Welcome to video lecture. I am Dr. C. Kavita, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, Satyabhama Institute of Science and Technology, deemed to be university. Today's topic is linear differential equation for second and higher order with constant coefficients. Linear differential equation is differential equation by defining linear polynomials in the unknown functions and its derivatives. Let us recall some basic definitions such as order and degree of a differential equation. Order is nothing but highest derivative of the differential equation. Degree is power of the highest derivative. Take for an example, d square y by dx square the whole cube plus 4 into dy by dx the whole power 4 plus 5y is equal to 0. Here highest derivative is said to be d square y by dx square. So order is nothing but 2. And the degree is power of the highest derivative. That means highest derivative power here it is 3. Therefore, degree is equal to 3. Now, let us say about the given example for first order linear differential equation. Dy by dx plus 2y is equal to e power x. Here order is 1. Order is nothing but highest derivative. So, order is equal to 1. So, it is said to be first order linear differential equation. Similarly, we can say about second order linear differential equation. That is d square y by dx square plus 4 into dy by dx plus 5y is equal to sin x. Here the highest derivative is 2. Therefore, order is equal to 2. Similarly, we can write the nth order linear differential equation. Nth order linear differential equation we can write for an example as d power n y divided by dx power n plus d power n minus 1 y divided by dx power n minus 1 plus etc. 5y is equal to e power minus x. This is an example. Now here this 4, 5 stands to be the constant, and the right hand side sin x, e power minus x and e power x are termed to be function. Now we can generalize this. When you generalize this, this constants can be named as a naught, a1, a2, etc., an. And functions are named as capital X. Therefore, we can define the general term as to be a naught d power n y by dx power n plus a1 d power n minus 1 y by divided by dx power n minus 1 etc. etc. an minus 1 dy by dx plus an y is equal to x. Here d by dx represent the differential operator. That means we can take, for simplification, we can take d by dx is equal to capital D. Therefore, this equation can be rewritten as a naught into d power n y plus a1 into d power n minus 1 y plus etc. an y is equal to x. Here y is a common term for all the variables. So, we can take y as common. This is nothing but function of d. It is a polynomial in d. That means I can write it, this as f of d into y is equal to x, where x stands for functions of x. F of d stands for polynomial in d. Now, for finding the solution for this one, I can take the right hand side to be 0. If I take this right hand side to be 0 means this equation becomes a homogeneous equation. And the general solution for equation 2 is, I can write it as y is equal to u plus v. Why I am writing y is said to be the dependent variable. It is depending on the independent variable x. Therefore, the solution will be in terms of y is equal to u plus v, where u is equal to complementary function and v is said to be the particular integral. Complementary function contains many number of arbitrary constant, but particular integral contains no constant. Now, to find the complementary function, the procedure is we have to take the right hand side is equal to 0 and you have to write down the auxiliary equation. Auxiliary equation is written by replacing d is equal to m and equating that function to be equal to 0. Therefore, the equation becomes a naught m power n plus a1 m power n minus 1 plus etc. an equal to 0, which is a nth degree algebraic equation in m. Solution of the function depends on the nature of the roots of the auxiliary equation. Now, there are three cases to find the complementary function. Case 1, the roots of the auxiliary equation are real and distinct, say m1, m2, etc., mn. For this, the complementary function is c1 into e to the power m1x, where c1 represent the constant, m1 represent the first root, plus c2 into e to the power m2x, here m2 represent the second root, etc., etc., up to nth root we can write. Here there is no particular integral, therefore the solution contains only the complementary function. So it is written as y is equal to complementary function alone. Now next, case 2, roots of the auxiliary equation are equal. Equal means, say for example, here 3 roots are same. That is m1 equal to m2 equal to m3, is both 3 roots are same. We can take it as m. Remaining roots we can start from m4 etc. up to mn. Therefore the solution can be written as c1 x square plus c2 x plus c3 into e to the power mx plus the remaining roots will be written as like previous one. That is if the roots are real and distinct. Now case 3. Roots are imaginary. Imaginary means it will be of the form alpha plus or minus I beta. Say m1 equal to alpha plus I beta and m2 is equal to alpha minus I beta. Then the complementary function will be written as e to the power alpha x into c1 cos beta x plus c2 sin beta x plus remaining all the roots are real and distinct as like case 1 you have to write. Now we can see different problems of this pattern. Say for example 1, solve d square minus 4d plus 3 into y is equal to 0. Now here this is an linear ordinary differential equation. Find the complementary function, we have to replace d by m, that is we want to find out the auxiliary equation. So when you replace d by m and equating to 0, this becomes m square minus 4m plus 3 is equal to 0. Here product is 3, sum is equal to minus 4. Therefore the roots are minus 1 and minus 3. It can be written as m minus 1 into m minus 3 is equal to 0. Therefore m is equal to 1 as well as 3. Now here the roots are real as well as distinct. Therefore according to case 1 we have to write. Case 1, here the roots are real and distinct. Here we have only 2 roots. Therefore the equation can be written as c1 into e to the power first root, that is 1 into x, plus c2 into e to the power second root, that is 3 into x. Again in this problem there is no particular integral, that is there is no function in the right hand side. Therefore the particular integral value is equal to 0. Now the general solution you will be writing it as y is equal to complementary function plus particular integral. Therefore y is nothing but c1 into e power x plus c2 into e power 3x. Now we can see another example, example 2. Solve d square plus cd plus 9 into y is equal to 0. Again it is a linear differential equation. Now to find the auxiliary equation, replace d by m and equate to 0. That means m square plus 6m plus 9 is equal to 0. Now here the product is 9 and sum is equal to 3. And now it is of the form a plus b the whole square. So I can write it as m plus 3 the whole square is equal to 0. Therefore the roots are minus 3 and minus 3. Therefore the complementary function, it comes under the second type. Second type is if the roots are equal means we can write like this. So same pattern we are following here. Here only 2 roots are equal. Therefore only you will have 2 constant. That means you can write it as c1x plus c2 into e to the power minus 3x. If there are 3 roots are equal means it should be written as c1x square plus c2x plus 3c3 into e power that root into x. Similarly if there are 4 roots means it should be written as c1x cube plus c2x square plus c3x plus c4 into e to the power that root into x. So and again here in this problem particular integral is equal to 0, therefore y, the solution we can write it as y is equal to complementary function plus particular integral. Therefore y is equal to c1x plus c2 into e to the power minus 3x. Now we can go for the third example. Third example is solve d square plus 4 into y is equal to 0. Again to find the auxiliary equation, replace d by m and equate it to 0. Therefore m square plus 4 is equal to 0. That means m square is equal to minus 4. Now make the left hand side as well as right hand side in terms of square. That means I can write minus is nothing but I square value is minus 1. So in the place of minus I can replace it as I square into t square. Now that implies m is equal to plus or minus I into 2. Now it is of the form alpha plus or minus I beta. Here which is nothing but 0 plus or minus I into 2. In the place of alpha you have the value has to be 0 and in the place of beta you have the value has to be 2. Therefore according to case 3 it should be written as complementary function is equal to e to the power alpha x. Alpha here the value is 0, that means 0 x into c1 cos beta x. Beta value is said to be 2, c1 cos 2x plus c2 sin 2x. And again e power 0 is 1, therefore the complementary function is nothing but c1 cos 2x plus c2 sin 2x. Finally, you have to write the solution. Solution is written in terms of complementary function and particular integral. Therefore, y is equal to c1 cos 2x plus c2 sin 2x. Hope you all enjoyed this video lecture. In the future, we can see the particular integral problems. Thank you.